My name is Johan Falk. I'm a mathematics teacher in Stockholm, Sweden. This is a video where I have a Freepager. I've got a question on how to set up Freepager to work with blog posts, so you can browse the blog post written by a particular user. So I'm going to try to do that now. This is the first time I'm doing this particular example, so you might I might do some mistakes every now and then, but you'll follow that. So I have my kind of standard installation here with admin menu. I have the module filters module, which is pretty useful, and I'm going to enable page manager. Page manager, I'm going to use the as well. I've also set up a content type called blog post, which is just nothing fancy at all. And I've added like 6-7 dummy users to this. So the first thing you'll need is a page where you will be browsing content, but the blog post. See a blog post in the actually make sure that the node is accessible and viewable by the user. And let's also make sure that the content type is a blog post, so you don't get this page for the media. Now we have pages to see all the blog posts written by a user. Now I'm going to add a view that allows us to click through, go to the next blog post, the next blog post. Now I'm going to have a view that takes an argument, and that is a user ID. For that user ID, we should have all the blog posts written by that user. So let's see. Do we have the view ID? Yep, content filter ID. I'm going to add this as a contextual filter. And if we don't have anything, this means we can't take it as a context from the user ID. We could actually do this for this one. Let's pick pop component 2. That's right. First, second. We're going to need the path for the previous and next thing here, so we're going to do a rewrite here. Rewrite the output of the results to /. Here we are. Okay, so if I go back here now to the panel, I can embed this view. No, okay, so we've done all these stuff blocks. That's bad because that block will be loaded on every page, holding every page. Resources. But let's do that right now. Let's put that to the sidebar first. Now, on this post here, views will be called and views will generate a list of all the blog posts written by user 2 and will output this as a free page. So I can go forward to the next blog post, the next blog post, the next blog post, go back to the previous one. This is being called even when I'm on the front page. The block is still called, but the path here doesn't match any of the paths in the view, so then the block is hidden. But the block is still called on every single page you have to put together. And if you have like 5,000 nodes on your site, it will become even heavier. So that's not fair. Let's see if I can do this with a standard node path as well. Hold on. We only want to list a blog post by a particular user. We should find a default value for a user and input from the URL. Also look for a node and use the node also. That should be enough. And we should have a node path. One of the fields must contain a path, which shows us which nodes, which path are included in this view. Brings us the does all the blog posts written by this user list them chronologically, and it takes it looks at this path field, it gets a list of quite a few of blog posts, looks at this path field and compares it to this path here, and if anyone matches, if it does, then it displays the previous and the next one, not like and there's no previous and the next. If you go to next, and so on. And you could go to and that's kind of it. I hope you find this useful. If we go to a user post here, the view will be called, but since none of the paths provided by this under view field here matches this path here, no block is set. The block is still called when the view is built, so it's resource heavy. And that's it. I hope that helps. See you some other time.